Good evening and welcome to the Kennedy Center. Please join me in welcoming tonight's Millennium Stage performance, Contemporary Romance.
Welcome to the beautiful and hallowed halls of the John F. Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts. Tonight, Bob, Vincent, and I are honored to perform a contemporary romance program here for you at the Millennium Stage, a stage which effectively and positively ensures that the performing arts are acceptable to our community and our nation. Thank you to all of the Kennedy Center staff and techies for their kindness and support, and to all of you that took the time to attend and to listen to our live stream this evening. We've topsy-turvied the timeline to begin with the contemporary of our romantic selections. Our first two selections are written by composers who were born in the 1960s, who are alive and vibrant, and whom both Bob and I have had a chance to work with while learning their repertoire. Gary Schocker's work has a light and contemplative first movement, and his Resolutions movement is joyously filled with momentum. Lowell Lieberman's two-movement sonata begins contemplatively, but mesmerizingly darker in feel. His second movement is Bacchus on steroids. So we'll meet you at the end of these two selections.
Thank you. Thank you.
we turn back our musical timeline to end our program with one of the most romantic compositions of the 19th century, the Sonata in A by César Franck. Composed in 1886, originally for violin and piano, this sonata was composed as a wedding gift to Franck's friend, the brilliant Belgian violinist, composer, and conductor, Eugene Ysaÿe. The story is Franck did not attend the wedding, but had the score presented to Ysaÿe and his bride by their mutual friend, Charles Bordes, the very morning of Ysaÿe's wedding. And yes, after a hurried rehearsal, Ysaÿe and Bordes's sister-in-law, the pianist, played the sonata to the other wedding guests. Now, this is astounding to me and very humbling, since it took me 40 years to learn this piece. And to imagine playing it on your wedding day, just seeing the score for the first time. So within the context of the wedding gift scenario, I believe strongly that Franck wanted to reflect to Ysaÿe those stages, specifically four movements we all go through when we marry the loves of our lives. The first movement sets the endless warmth, hope, and joy of romance, and hope that we all experience, followed by a very tumultuous second movement, yes, with people shouting, trying to understand one another, followed by the third movement of contemplation and some decision-making in what should we do with this love, sometimes difficult and exciting union, which is very normal. And finally, what I think is the deepest understanding of love, that thanks to time, a joyous onward triumphs as the truest of momentum. Thank you.
Thank you.